all alone. Don't wanna waste another whisper on the phone. Well, I got the top down under the moonlight. I got your honey on my mind. Don't wanna waste no more time.
And I'm Glossy. This is my YouTube channel, my makeup tutorial channel, whatever you call it. I did this Festive AF makeup tutorial. I was gonna do this for Christmas, but since I'm home during this time of the night, I can't do it today. Anyways, you guys, I had a lot of fun filming this look for you guys. And you see right here, I don't usually do a red lip or a bold lip with a crazy eye look, but because this is my Festive AF tutorial, I thought might as well, you know, yeah, I know it's a little much, but I would never wear this outside, but if it was like a certain like event or occasion, I would definitely go out. But I kind of look like a hooker, but whatever, I'm awesome. I just, you know, why not? I'm at home, I'm in the house, might as well, you know, add that extra crop, and why not do it for today's tutorial? Yeah, I had a lot of fun filming this tutorial. I did like a really cheek highlight, which I love this red lip. I used a different red lip in today's tutorial. I love it. And I don't know, I did a glitter eye. Like, I'm living for this color. You guys can, if you guys don't want to do a red lip, you guys don't have to. You could totally do a nude lip as well, which I do this look all the time with a nude lip. Like, I wear this like not on special occasions. People think I'm crazy, but yeah. I don't know. I didn't want to do a lower, I wanted to do a lower lash line, something really different that I do here on my channel, but I just be anyways, guys, I had so much fun filming this tutorial. Yeah, and if you guys, if you look throughout my channel, I love when you guys put me for like how mama, you know? Yeah, so let me know if you do this look, subscribe to my channel, or you won't know about my updates. I gotta pee really badly, I'm hungry, gotta clean the house, I have a lot to do, but I just wanted to wake up, film for you guys, have some fun, and I'm probably gonna edit this video tonight, and I'll be up for you guys tomorrow. Yeah, so tomorrow's look, I think I'm gonna do a turquoise gold glitter smoky purple eye. I think that's gonna be fun and do like a little bit of a nude lip. I like to, you know, do a red lip or a bold lip, and then the next day I'll do a nude. I like to change it up a little bit, but yeah, so I'm not gonna do a super long intro like I usually do, but I hope you guys enjoy this video. If you guys want to see how I did this look on today's channel video, just keep on watching. I love you guys so much, and don't be sick. Bye. Hey y'all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So for today's look, I'm gonna do a festive look. Yeah, I just wanted to do something really different today. I know it's not like a holiday or anything, but I don't feel like I need a certain holiday to do this look today. It's gonna be a pretty intense look. I'm just using this Kopari lip glossy just because my lips are so dry, and I just want to do something real intense. And to focus more on the eyes, I'm just gonna, you know, did my base already. So to set everything in and make all my powders really like soaking in the skin and very melted, I'm just gonna go in with the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. Also, it's really hot today in Vancouver, so this is just gonna like cool everything and kind of just make my skin dewy and glowy. But look, my lips are definitely like not as swollen as today. I'm telling you, if you guys have super chapped or swollen lips, use honey and coconut oil, put it in a container, make a paste, leave it on 5 to 10 minutes, remove it. It helps, I tell you. Okay, so for eyeshadow, I'm actually going to go in with an eyeliner. So this is the ColourPop Cream Gel Color Besto. So this is just going to be the base because we want this look to be really intense. We're going to do kind of like a red, glittery, smoky eye. So I want the color to really show. If you guys want the eyeshadow to be really pigmented, you can use concealer. You can use like a darker like cream gel liner. You can use a MAC has a lot of them. Obviously, Makeup Forever because they're a makeup artist brand. Anything like this, but I'm just going to use this ColourPop one because we're going in with a gel. A gel cream liner as the base for the eyeshadow. I didn't powder my eyes because it's not going to show as much. So basically, I just put foundation on my eyelids and concealer, but I didn't powder my eyelids because basically you don't want the cream and powder to mix because it won't look right. It'll be a little bit cakey. So, okay. I want to start with, this is the Morphe E17 brush. I love this brush for applying like anything cream on my eyelids because it's really fluffy and you can really blend. And because this was a little dry, I just sprayed some setting mist in the pot and I'll kind of not be dry. It'll regain the consistency. So I like let it soak for a bit. That's like what I do. I do it with like any brow pomade or like the Anastasia DIPBROW. It tends to be really dry over time. And you can also do it with cream liner. I used to put oil, but oil and creams don't mix, trust me. Okay, so that should be enough. So before we go in, I'm just going to lift my eye and just like pat it like that. Just all in the lid area. Like that. It's hard to see because I have like no fucking eyelids. So just pat that in. I love applying cream to the eyelid just to like make the color show more because when we apply the actual eyeshadow to the lid, it's just gonna pop. And I'm gonna show you guys how I do this. I do this like all the time for like any intense look that I do. It's like a little bit dry, but I always like to do a little at a time. I don't want to go too crazy in here. So it's just mainly like pop that right in the lid. This color is a little bit purple. Like I would like it to be more red, but I didn't have it. It's just the only one I have. I did have the NYX one. I don't know what it's called, but it's red. NYX has like a cream liner. It's not good, trust me. That one like was not working. I had to throw it out because it was so dry. I tried everything to make it not dry. It didn't work for me. But this is what I'm doing. It's kind of like a purpley kind of cream liner, but it's gonna pop. So just like that. ColourPop does have a red one, but always sold out when I want to buy it. I do want the MAC one though. But this is what I'm going to use for today's look. Just because I want to try the Makeup Forever one. I think it's called like Artist XO or something and it's in a tube. And it's just like, I heard really good things about it. Like you can use it as a liner. You can use it as like a cream base, like whatever you want. Okay. So we're just gonna like pop that in the lid really lightly. All in the corner. Don't worry about getting it like super nicely in the lid because we're gonna blend it out with shadow and with a clean brush after. Okay. Just spraying my setting spray in that liner. Yeah, that's a trick I learned. Like, water doesn't work really well, but I find setting spray just kind of activates it and kind of makes it more, like, creamy and not as dry. And oil doesn't work. 38. We're just gonna have no product on this brush, and we're just gonna basically just go over in that crease area just to blend out that purple cream liner. We just want it to be smooth and pigmented. Just basically like blend it. I got some down here, but that's okay. that's better. I think I'm going to use some translucent powder just to set the under eye. So we're going to play with some like darker reds and do like some smokiness. I'm just using the Fenty Beauty Lavender Powder. I'm just going to like pat this under the eye. Because I don't want fallout for today's look. Hill palette from Morphe, and I'm gonna go in with Creamsicle, and I'm just gonna use the R37. I just want to kind of like apply a really light transition shade, and this is just gonna be like it's gonna be really refreshing just to like blend this out. Okay, so I'm just gonna apply that Creamsicle color and kind of blend that purpley liner color out. And this is gonna like create that cat eye, just like that. I love this color. It's such a beautiful transition color. More like people get scared using yellow as a transition color, but it just kind of like adds a very light kind of transition area, if that makes sense. Shade. We're going to go in with the Morphe 433. And because I want to do like a red, smoky, kind of purpley eye, I'm going to go in with this red burgundy color. This is called Jax. Yeah. It's really pretty. You just tap the excess off and just kind of pop it right on top of that cream liner we put from ColourPop. And kind of like go in the crease. Like that, yeah. See, now it's like kind of like red purpley when this just looks purple. So like, you guys don't have to use the exact color. Like say like I want to do a red color, you don't have to use the exact like same cream liner. Like you can always use like a purpley one. As long as it has like a red undertone or similar to what the eyeshadow you're doing, it works the same thing. Because at first I was like, I don't know how I feel. But I think you need to buy a red cream liner. They're just really hard to find, and I haven't had a chance to since, you know, we've been stuck in quarantine. But once the mall's open, I'm the first one there. Okay, we're going to do the other eye now. Yeah, that's looking better. See, that just makes it more so, like, vibrant, intense, because we added that cream liner to the lid. So, basically, it just adds, like, as a base to the lid. Like if you guys like feel like the shadow or the palette you're using isn't bright enough, you guys can always do that. Just add like a cream or like a paint pot. Like MAC has a lot of different paint pots. Like they have one that's like a dark brown that you can use, and it just makes the eyeshadow that you're using more intense. It's just like a makeup artist thing trick that you do. Smoky and cat eye. Okay, and then we're just going to use the R37, and I'm just dipping in that creamsicle color. And we're just going to like blend that burgundy red color, and I'm just kind of like blending those colors because it's not as blended and I don't want any harsh lines. I want this to be really blended because we used a cream liner too. And it just looks better with that yellow just above that red burgundy color. I love using like yellows for transition colors because it blends really well like with any darker reds. The same brush, this is the M433, and we're gonna go in with Hunt. This kind of like, what color is this? This is like kind of like intense orangey red. Just using the same brush, just going right in between that Jax color and that creamsicle color, just right in the crease there, the line of the crease. Okay, and then I'm just going to use Creamsicle with that R37 brush again. Tap the excess off and just blend right over top of that. Because we're going with darker, kind of reddish, smoky eyes. I want this eyeshadow look to be really blended. Cute. Some fun. Because I love to have fun. Okay, I'm gonna basically do a cut crease with some concealer. I use the Kylie Cosmetics concealer. I really do love her concealers because they're very like hydrating and it's more like paste. It's definitely full coverage, but it's not like heavy or thick, but I just wanted to use it in this tutorial. I believe this color is called Jimson. Because I think this one's Himalayan. So Himalayan is more of a pinky. And then Jimson is like a lighter peach, I believe. I'm going to use the lighter one. Stay. And then I'm just going in with the M421. This is my favorite concealer brush for cutting out my lid. So it's so small and it's perfect for my lid because I got small lids. Okay. Actually, I'm going to put this down here because I'm going to apply eyeshadow right when I apply this because I want the concealer wet when I apply eyeshadow over top. So basically, I'm just going to cut the crease with this. Just in the inner corner there. And I'm going to stamp it at the end there. Like that. Okay, while that's still wet and tacky, I'm just going to grab the MAC 242 brush and I'm going to go in with Queen, this really pretty gold color. I used to do both eyes at the same time. But then I realized, like, I need the concealer tacky. So we're just going to spray the brush with some setting spray with that cream color. And we're just going to pack this wherever we packed the concealer on. Yeah, because you need the concealer to be tacky and wet. Because the eyeshadow will actually stick to the lid where you apply that concealer. So I usually do one eye at a time, and then I'll do the other eye. And then at the end, I just kind of like feather it to that darker red color. We don't want like the whole lid cover, but most of it. Like that. So pretty. Okay, now we're going to do the other eye really quickly. Okay, that's looking really good. Okay, and then we're going to have some more fun. I'm going to use this pigment. I believe this is from Modern Basic, and I've used their stuff before. It's pretty affordable. Usually they buy this brand for kits and stuff. I got this in my kit, but I believe this is from Modern Basic. I'll check it out. This is in bronze. It's a pigment. It's super, like, gold bronzy, and I'm kind of into it. I'm just going to use the MAC 242. And I'm just gonna pat this in the brush. It's a little bit lighter than this gold color. I'm gonna spray the brush. So the pigments I always do. And we're just gonna pat this really light in the inner corner. And it's gonna make it really gold and bronzy. Just felt like having some fun, playing with some pigments. Okay, I'm going to go in with the MAC Cosmetics Pro Longwear Fluid Line in the shade Black Track. I just want to do eyeliner because we're going to do a darker lower lash line, and I just want to do this first because it'll blend out the black. I'm going in with the Morphe M443. Okay, we're just going to outline the lower lash line, the waterline. I can't really see, so it's hard. Like, when you look in a mirror, it's not the same as a camera as the mirror. But I want you guys to see, so I'll always go in with the camera first. And we're gonna blend it with the definer. Okay, that's done. I'm going to use this definer, guys. This is the Morphe 423. I loved using this brush for my lower lash line. And I think I'm going to do a green today. So I'm going to go in with Enchanted. It's this really pretty forest green color. I love it. Okay, we're just going to apply this all in the lower lash line. And this is the part where it's going to blend that black waterline liner. Like that. I know I look crazy, but it's going to come together. Use the Morphe from the Rose Gold collection. This is the R41. I love using this brush. And then I'm going to go in with the Shimmery Green Diva. I usually don't like using shimmery colors to blend the lower lash line, but I think this color is going to be really pretty with this darker green. And I just want to be different today. But sometimes I do use it, and it adds something to it. It looks festive, and I'm into it. And it's just going to blend out. That green color. Yeah. I love it. Bitch, yes! Yeah, you guys should try it out. Like, if you guys want to do something different, just add, like, a glitter or a shimmer in your lower lash line, like, blending it with a darker lower lash line. Looks really pretty. It's just something different I've done. Last few times on my channel. Okay, now I'm actually going to highlight my brow bone with this Makeup Forever Starlight Powder in the shade of 13 Ivory. I've been loving using this as my brow highlight. I don't know, I'm into it. I'm just going to use this smudger guy. This is the Morphe M213. I'm just gonna tap this right on the brow bone. Corner. I think I'm just going to use Enlight and Beam because I haven't used these in a while. Just crazy up in here, guys. Okay, I'm going to go in with this bullet guide. This is the Morphe M455. Just going to dip, spray my brush, just tap this in the inner corner. I want more of a whiter highlight today. The Morphe times Jaclyn Hill Armed and Gorgeous palette, we're going to go in this VIP shade. Just because I want a really white inner corner, and I'll match with that brow highlight we did today. Oh yeah, that's a little intense. Well, I'm with it. Since we did a really intense eye, I don't really care if I go too crazy in the inner corner, because if you're going to go dramatic, you might as well go dramatic. I'm going to be real honest. Okay, now I'm just going to go in with the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette, and I'm just using this Y11 brush just to apply these two highlighting shades under the eye. And I want to do this before I apply glitter, so then I'll look up, and when I have glitter on, I won't look, like, I don't like to look up because it'll get glitter everywhere, and you'll ruin the base of your eyeshadow, basically. Just apply this all under the under eye. So I love under eye highlight. Are you kidding me? Just makes it look so beautiful, especially when you're pale. Just kind of like glitter now. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go in. This is the NYX Glitter Primer. I love this glitter primer. You can use, like, Lit Cosmetics has one. Eye Candy has one. It's called, like, their theme is, like, eye sugar. So it's, like, a liquid eye sugar. So it's, like, the same thing. I believe Makeup Forever has one. It's, like, called Mixing Liquid. MAC has one. It's called Mixing Medium. It's, like, in a little thing. But this is my favorite. I like it because it's, like, kind of like a paste and it's easy to apply. And I always like to use a synthetic brush. I believe this one's from Morphe. I think this is the M224. It's kind of worn off, but you can use any synthetic brush. I also have this one too. This is the M224. I think this is the newer one, and they got rid of this one, but I like this one better. And then for glitter, I think I'm going to use this one. This is the Makeup Forever Starlit Glitter in S603. This is my favorite. So I'm just going to use this one because I love it. It's kind of like it's like not a gold, but it's like a sandy kind of gold, and I love it. So we're just going to squeeze this NYX Glitter Primer on the back of my hand. This stuff is good, but if you guys can't find this one, also Too Faced has one as well. They have an eyeshadow one and then the glitter one. I've used that one before too, but honestly, this is the same thing. I love this NYX one. Plus, it's affordable. You can get it at any drugstore that sells NYX, and I love it. So we're just going to take some on the back of that synthetic brush, and we're just going to pat all in the inner corner. Wherever you want that glitter, that's where you apply. Don't add too much. Just like enough. We're going to dip in the glitter, that glitter primer, still on the brush. Okay. And just pat wherever you put that glitter primer. Like that. Ooh, yeah. I kind of put it everywhere. Who cares? I love using this glitter primer because it doesn't get messy, doesn't go everywhere. I just love it. I'm just going to wipe the brush off. It's like, I like to use like a damp cotton pad because if it's too wet, it kind of changes the consistency when you dip that powder in again. Okay, I'm going to do the other eye. See, so I'm telling you that NYX glitter primers are the best. I believe Nikki Tutorials loves this as well. And I love her. I love me some Nikki. I don't care if she's trans, to be honest. It's 2020. Get over it, bitches. Like, look at Jeffree Star. He's like, he's not a woman or a man per se, but I think he is, like, he has his part still. But, that's, he just dresses like that, but whatever. Okay, now I'm gonna do mascara. That's your choice. You know, you gotta let people live. Just saying. Okay, we're gonna use the L'Oreal Luminous Lash Paradise in Black is Black. I love this mascara. We're just gonna quickly coat my lashes. Oh my god, I'm loving this look. Wait till I put fake lashes on this. I'm having obsessed. So cute. It's a really thin coat. Flutter lashes, these are the double lift lashes in Intoxicating. These are my favorite lashes of all time. And I'm just gonna put this baby on. I just wanna see how it looks with the glitter. Oh, yes! Yes, yes, yes! Okay, I'm into it. I love these lashes. They're so beautiful. They're so long. They're so thick. They're so voluminous. They're literally my perfect lash. I love the name. They have another one called Captivating. It's also really beautiful as well, but they're not as long as the Intoxicating. So I'm just going to apply some lash glue really quickly. I'm just cleaning my tweezers. I'm just going to use the tweezers. I'm just going to pop this in on my lashes. I love this Makeup Forever glitter. Like, you can use it with a bronzy look, like a gold eyeshadow on top. It's just, like, so versatile. Because I know I did in my bronzy makeup tutorial, and I used this glitter. It looked so bronzy. And then with this look, it looks really, like, gold. So I used a gold shadow underneath the other eye. Like that. On the shade and light palette, I'm going to use these two contour shades. And what brush do I want to use? I'm going to use this Morphe 530 brush. I love this brush, you guys know. Just love it because it gives you a really precise contour, that's all. Okay, we're going to suck in our cheeks. Yeah, because I'm so pale right now. I don't want too dark of a contour right now. Just because. Just like being different because I kind of want a bronzy kind of look because I'm so pale right now. I think I'm going to go in with Hoola and Hoola Caramel. And this is the Benefit Cheek Leader Bronze Squad. It so cute. And I think I'm going to use a different bronzer brush. I'm going to use this one. This is the E18. This is the Morphe Elite Collection. This is E2. It's kind of like crumbled, but whatever. Just going to dip in both. I love me some hula bronzer. I love this brush too. It just applies the bronzer so beautiful. It's such a soft, like it's so soft. Okay, perfect. That's actually pretty good. Okay, now we're gonna just bake really quickly. I'm just gonna use the Laura Mercier Translucent Loose Setting Powder. I love using this for the bakage of the bottom of my face. I just wanna clean up in here really quickly. I'm just going to go in with Hoola bronzer just to contour the nose because I think Hoola caramel will be too dark if I mix them both. I'm just going to use this Kylie brush. This is her slanted goat hair. There's no number on it, but slanted goat hair. It's red. I bought it from her Christmas collection because I love it. Okay, we're just going to lightly contour the nose. Von D shade and light palette. We're going to use these two highlighting shades again, and I'm just going to go in with the Y11 Morphe brush from the Gold collection. I'm just going to pat this all on the chin area just to give it some depth and dimension. I think I'm just going to go in with my MAC blush palette. I'm going to go in with Melba because I'm really pale. I just kind of want like a peachy kind of glow. Just going to use the Morphe Gold Collection in Y4 with Melba. Just a really peachy glow. You know? I don't want something too crazy for today's blush. By the way, speaking of blushes, I still haven't got my Ofra blush palette. I got it sent to my house, not to my work, just because I'm not sure when exactly I'm going back to work. I know they said mid-May. Like, my mom told me to go back to work the 19th, but it's kind of in the air right now. I don't know what's happening. In Luminous Light, I love this powder, and I'm going to go in with the Morphe M500. I just want to like diffuse the blush and add an extra glow, you know, just let it be glowing today. I want to do it like more gold. Let me think. Oh my god, I have powder all over my shirt. Who cares? I think I'm just going to use this Makeup Forever Pro Light Fusion Undetectable Luminizer in the shade 02. And I think because we did glitter highlights, it's just going to add that extra pop, you know? I'm just going to apply this really lightly to the skin. Yeah. Yes, honey. Yes, yes, yes. Makeup Forever using the sponge really lightly. And then I just want to add it to the tip of the cheeks. Like that, yeah. It just kind of adds, like, gives you like this really seamless highlight, which I love it. I'm gonna use the shade Cookie, but I've used that highlight so much on my channel. I just want to do this one because it's more gold. I lit a powder in the shade 13 Ivory, and this is gonna make this look take it there. I think I used this in my last video, and I love it. It's just such a beautiful, like, loose powder. I'm just gonna apply this. Oh my god. Oh my god, honey. This look just took it there. I know it's a little intense, but I love it. Especially, we did such a crazy eye look today. I'm grabbing and I'm kind of into it. Okay, I'm going to use a red lip liner first. I'm going to go in with Morphe color pencil and high maintenance. I love this red lip color. This is my go-to red lip liner of all time. I'm just going to sharpen it really quickly. It's not that sharp, but whatever. I love this red lip liner. I'm in it. It's like orange red. Totally in it. Okay, I'm gonna use a red lip. I'm just gonna move some stuff. Okay, so this is the red lip color I'm gonna use. This is from YSL. I love this one because it's like not matte. So this is the Tatouage Couture Matte Satin. So it's like not a matte lip color, but more of a satin, and I love it. And this is in the shade number 12. It's like, it has this kind of cool applicator, really innovative. But if you're shaky, don't use this because it's kind of hard to apply. But it's such a beautiful red. It's really pretty. So I'm just gonna apply this everywhere. It's a really cool applicator, though. It's definitely like more red than Morphe Hot Shot, like what I usually use. But I like the formula. Like, it's super thin. It's not super thick. But it's pretty. But you gotta get used to how to use this applicator because it's just different. But I'm kind of into it. Just something different. I don't usually do like a red lip with this kind of bold color, but I'm kind of into it. I just want to do something different on my channel. I usually won't do this type of look, like going outside. I'll do a nude lip, but I'm into it. Now we're just gonna apply some Morphe continuous setting mist all over the skin. Just to seal the deal. But I feel like I could wear this lip all day because it's like not super dry in that. So like if you guys I try to wear like matte bold lip colors. I don't like to wear gloss, but you could just wear this and this would be good. We'll see how it wears for the day. Okay, I'm just going to use some Anastasia brow gel to seal the deal on these babies. Okay, And then now for lower lash mascara, I'm just going to use the MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash. I love this mascara for the lower lash line. Okay, that's looking real good. I'm just going to curl my hair real quickly, you guys. I'll be right back. So it's a little like it has that stickiness. I don't know. I'm trying not to dry my hair because drying your hair out just kind of like damages your hair. So sometimes I'll just air dry, especially because it's been so hot lately. It is May, but that's it for this tutorial. I love this, doing this makeup look so much. I know it's a little much with the red lip, but I just wanted to show you guys that YSL Satin Matte lip. Yeah, it looks super hydrating. It's not super like cakey. It's easy to apply. Where are you, YSL? Where are you? Let me go get her in shade number 12. I love this red lip. It's like more of a true red lip than anything. Yeah, I don't know. I loved it. And I love the applicator. And it's just so innovative. It's not like completely pigmented, because I find, yeah, see, like it does come off. It's not. And I did have some lipsticks so I had to reapply. It is expensive, but it's YSL. YSL always comes out with bomb-ass products. Now my hand's all red. But, yeah, like, it doesn't stay on completely. It does kind of fade, like, if you're drinking a lot or, like, kissing people. But I don't really like to kiss my boyfriend when I have red lips, just my opinion. But I loved how festive this looked. It's just, like, a really fun lip color. And I loved how this look ended up. I just had like a lot of fun doing this tutorial, and I love this. I think it's like my new favorite highlight. I do have some texture because I am like super dry. I'll probably do like a mask in a few days. I did one yesterday, but I did a clay mask. I usually like to use more than one mask if my skin is super super dry. But I know I'd never do like a crazy red lip with a blinging, banging, a smoky glitter eye, but I just love how festive it looks. It looks blinging, and of course I had to add my favorite earrings from Irie Me collection. Yeah, I had so much fun filming this tutorial for you guys. I just wanted to film earlier because I have a lot of stuff to do around the house right now. I have a lot to clean, but I wanted to film for you guys first, and I'll probably edit my video after I clean, eat, do some stuff around the house. But yeah, I love this tutorial. I hope you guys love this tutorial, and I just love it. I love how festive this looks. Yeah, I would wear this all the time, but I do wear this look a lot of the time with a nude lip, but I just wanted to do a red lip. You guys could totally bang this out with a red lip, just saying. For tomorrow's tutorial, I wanted to do something different. Probably not as crazy as today's look, but I wanted to do like a turquoise gold, a smoky, a purple eye. And I just want to add some pop, some color, some glitter, and play with a nude lip, I think. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do for tomorrow's look. I just want to do something different. After that, I might do another tutorial with a red lip, because I don't usually like to apply a lot of red lip colors, just because, I don't know, like, I don't think red lips look good on me, but a lot of people do. Like, my mom loves red lips, but I think because I don't wear them all the time. But I definitely want to do more of red lips on my channel because I don't do all the time. But if you guys need, like, a fantastic red lip, I suggest using the YSL one. And I love, like, if they had more nudes in their collection, I would buy those, but this is definitely like a really pretty true red, one of my favorites, but it's just not 100% waterproof. Like Jeffree Star, like nothing goes through Jeffree Star. It lasts all night, all day. And MAC Cosmetics, they have one too. I might use this one in one of my tutorials. This is Feel So Grand. Haven't used this on my channel yet. And I also have a Morphe one called Morphe Red Lip, which I want to do on my channel. I was thinking doing like a romantic kind of glittery eye look with the red lip, but this one's also like really waterproof. Nothing will go through this, but this is more of a matte. I find with like a lot of satin lip colors, they're not 100% waterproof and they do like wear off compared to actual like matte lip colors. I find like they last longer, but also they're more drying. So you just have to like weigh your options, like what you're really looking for and what you really enjoy. Like I would wear this, but you just would have to reapply it throughout the night. But the thing with satin lip is like when you reapply matte lipstick, it gets goopy and gets dry. With the satin lip, it doesn't get that. You just kind of like, I don't know, some people don't like to reapply lipstick. I am one of those people, but if it does wear off, I'll reapply it, just the purpose of the makeup tutorial. Anyways, you guys, yeah, I had a lot of fun filming this tutorial. So much fun filming this look. I did like some different things. I used those Kylie Cosmetics concealers. I love these concealers because they're really hydrating. It's more like a paste, and she definitely didn't steal a formula from anyone. So if you guys are really, really dry, this is the concealer for you, just because it's really hydrating. I have used her concealers before. I find it's a little like pasty and thick to use every day, but if you guys want a full beat of concealer, Kylie is one of the greatest. I just find it's a little I don't know, it's hard to apply because it is more of a paste and it's a bit of a thicker concealer. I just prefer the Tarte Shape Tape or my Jeffree Star or my Chouwer concealer. But yeah, but I definitely recommend this. This is a great concealer if you guys on the drier side because it seems really hydrating. But anyways, you guys, that's it for this makeup tutorial. I hope you guys enjoy. I'm trying not to make my intros and outros as long, but I'm going to film that turquoise, gold glitter, purple smoky eye for you tomorrow. Yeah, and I'm just going to add some glitter and do a little bit of a nude lip. Lots of fun. I just want to, you know, do a different look. Like, I don't want to do the same look in real, different looks for you guys here on my channel. Anyways, you guys, I love you so much. Have an amazing day today.
Wear your pretty black dress or your faded blue jeans, high heels or your pretty bare feet. Wear what you want, baby. It's you I wanna see. Nobody around us, only the sound of hearts in a raging fire, slowly melting the sky.